Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpandi. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is Module 2, First Law of Thermodynamics. This is lecture number 2 on the Module 2. We recap from the previous lecture. The previous lecture 201 for in the first law of thermodynamics, we discussed the first law of thermodynamics, and we proved that the energy is a property of the system, and we discussed the specific heats, specific heat at constant volume, specific heat at constant pressure. And here the topic for this lecture is the application of first law of thermodynamics to open system. And we are going to derive the steady flow energy equation. So the previous lecture we studied about the first law of thermodynamics, and we are going to apply the first law of thermodynamics for the open system in this lecture, and it leads to the derivation of steady flow energy equation. And the learning outcome for the lecture, the student will be able to derive steady flow energy equation, and they will be able to apply the steady flow energy equation for a nozzle, turbine, heat exchanger and throttling device. The steady flow energy equation. Steady flow means that the thermodynamic properties will have a fixed value at a particular location and will not change with respect to time. So the steady flow means the properties remains constant with respect to time. Properties do not change with respect to time. So they are constant. And we consider this device for the analysis, for the derivation of steady flow energy equation. And we have a small device, a rectangular duct. And here we have the inlet and the outlet. And the inlet pipeline is at a distance of Z1 from the datum. This is the reference datum, Z1. And the outlet is at the height of Z2, and this is the inlet point and this is the outlet point, and there is supply of heat energy to the system del Q by dt, and there is work produced by the system del W by dt. And we take these parameters A1, A2, the cross sectional area of the pipe at inlet and the outlet in meter square. M1, M2 is the mass flow rate at the inlet and the outlet in kilograms per second. P1 and P2 are the pressure at the inlet and the outlet of the pipe in Pascal or Newtons per meter square. V1 and V2 are the specific volume at the inlet and the outlet in meter cube per kilogram. Capital V1, capital V2 is the velocity at the inlet and the outlet in meters per second. U1 and U2 is the specific internal energy at the inlet and the outlet in joules per kilogram. And the Z1 and Z2 are the elevation above the datum at inlet and the outlet in meters. So these are all the various parameters. And del Q by dt is the net rate of heat transfer through the control surface in joules per second. And del W by dt is the net rate of work transfer through the control surface in joules per second. So these are all the parameters for the derivation of the steady flow energy equation. And by the conservation of mass, so the principle of conservation of mass says that the mass flow rate entering must be equal to mass flow rate leaving the system. So mass entering to the system is equal to mass leaving the system. So M1 equal to M2. So from the continuity equation, we find M equal to area into velocity divided by the specific volume. So A1, V1, A capital A1 is the area, capital V1 is the velocity, and small v1 is the specific volume. A1 v1 by small v1 equal to A2 v2 by small v2. That is the continuity equation or based on the conservation of mass. And the various forms of energy at the inlet. So we said any thermodynamic system, it possesses different forms of energy. What are all the energy we consider here for the derivation of steady flow energy equation? So potential energy, which is m1 g into z1. Kinetic energy, half mv square, that is half m1 v1 square. flow energy m1 into p1 v1, internal energy m1 into u1, and rate of heat input del q by dt. So these are all the energy into the system, and we take the total energy of the total energy entering the control volume, sum of all the values, potential energy, kinetic energy, flow energy, internal energy, and the heat energy. The first four terms, m1 is a common parameter. We take m1 outside. So into m1 into g z1 plus 1 by 2 v1 square plus v1 p1 v1 plus u1 equal plus del q by dt. Now we define the specific enthalpy. So in the earlier lecture, we defined the specific enthalpy, h equal to u plus pv. So h1 equal to u1 p1. Then this equation, so this is combined together. So u1 plus p1 v1 equal to h1. So m1 into g z1 plus 1 by 2 v1 square plus h1 equal h1 plus del q by dt is the total amount of energy entering into the system. So this is potential energy, kinetic energy, and enthalpy, which is the sum of internal energy and the flow energy. And similarly, total energy leaving the control volume, the same equation, m2 g into z2 1 by 2 v2 square and h2. Instead of heat transfer, there is work produced by the system. So del W by dt, that is what the amount of work input to the work output of the system. And the steady flow energy equation is based on the energy conservation principle. So energy conservation principle state that net energy entering into the system is equal to the net energy leaving the system. That is what the energy conservation principle. And therefore, energy entering into the system, m1 into g1 z1 plus 1 by 2 v1 square plus h1 plus del q by dt equal to m2 into g z2 plus 1 by 2 v2 square plus h2 in plus del w by dt. That is what the steady, this is the steady flow energy equation. Further, we will simplify from the continuity equation. So m1 equal to m2 equal to m, which is dm by dt, change in the mass with respect to time, mass flow rate. So divide this equation. So divide this equation by dm by dt. So you'll get g z1 plus 1 by 2 v1 square plus h1 plus del q by dm equal to g z2 plus 1 by 2 v2 square plus h2 plus del w by dm. This is what the again energy equation. Here this is with respect to mass. So heat transfer per unit mass, work done per unit mass. And the above equation is called as steady flow energy equation. So this equation we can also write as g z1 plus 1 by 2 v1 square plus h1 plus q equal to g z2 plus 1 by 2 v2 square plus h2 plus w, where q and w are the energy transfer per unit mass. So this equation you have to remember, and this is what the steady flow energy equation which will be using for solving the problem. And we have a reflection spot. Write the various energy included in this steady flow energy equation. So based on your observation, listening, so you write down the various forms of energy included in the steady flow energy equation. And these are all the energy: potential energy, kinetic energy, flow energy, internal energy, heat energy, and work energy. And these two are combined, and it is called as enthalpy. Flow energy and internal energy, they are combined together, and it is called as enthalpy. So these are all the energy for steady derivation of the steady flow energy equation. Now we apply the steady flow energy equation for a nozzle and diffuser. So the nozzle and diffuser, they are the similar type of devices, that is why we combined here. And nozzle is a device which increases the velocity by decreasing the pressure of the fluid. The diffuser just opposite. Diffuser is a device which increases the pressure but decreasing velocity of the fluid. So nozzle and diffuser are perfectly opposite, but the concept is the same. The general steady flow energy equation. So what we derived earlier. So g z1 plus 1 by 2 v1 square plus h1 plus q equal to g z2 plus 1 by 2 v2 square plus h2 plus w. Now we assume the nozzle is horizontal, nozzle is insulated. So the normally when the value, when all the values are given, you have to use the general expression. Majority of the cases, we assume that nozzle is insulated. So Q equal to 0, There is no work done when the fluid is flowing through the nozzle, so W equal to 0, and the inlet and the outlet are the same, that is Z1 equal to Z2, that is nozzle is horizontal. So the applying the conditions, so Q equal to 0, W equal to 0, Z1 and equal to Z2, dropping all the term, left, what are the terms left out? Left hand side H1 plus 1 by 2 V1 square and right hand side H2 plus 1 by 2 V2 square. And this is the nozzle and diffuser. So in the nozzle, is flow is accelerated, velocity is increasing. So in the diffuser, flow is decelerated, velocity is decreasing. And the final conclusion, 1 by 2 V1 square plus H1 equal to 1 by 2 V2 square plus H2. And the velocity at the outlet of the fluid, velocity of the fluid at the outlet V2 equal to square root of V1 square plus 2 into H1 minus H2. And in some majority of the cases, the exit velocity, the inlet velocity is very, very small comparing with the exit velocity. And so it is neglected. So in general, V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2, where the condition here, we have to remember. So you have to substitute H1 and H2 in joules per kilogram. Normally in the problem, H1 and H2 will be given in kilojoules per kilogram. You have to multiply by 1000. So this is V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2, where H1 and H2 is H1 and H2 are in joules per kilogram. So we take a turbine and compressor. So these two devices are again similar. That is why we combined here. And this is a simple gas turbine jet engine. So here we have the compressor at the entrance and the turbine at the other side. So the fluid air enters here, it is getting compressed. So for compression of the air, we supply the work. And the compressed air is going to the combustor where it is burnt and the hot gas are produced. The hot gas are expired in the turbine. So turbine is another device which is producing work. So compressor is absorbing work, turbine is producing work. So the both the devices are in principle of operation, both the devices are the same. That is why we have combined here. And this is another diagram. So the compressor, fresh air is coming here. It is getting compressed and it is leaving with the higher pressure. It is leaving here and it goes to the compression chamber where the heat is added here by burning the fuel. Then the hot gas are expanded the turbine. So turbine produces work. Normally in a gas turbine power plant, the work produced by the turbine is given to the compressor. The remaining work is available as a net work output. And the exhaust gas are led to the atmosphere. So turbine is producing work. The work is work produced by the turbine is given, partially it is given to the compressor. And the remaining is available as a external work output or net work output. And the steady flow energy equation for turbine, compressor, blower, fan and pump are very much similar. So turbine is a work producing device, whereas compressor, blower, fan and pump, they are the work absorbing devices. So the general form of the steady flow energy equation is like this. G Z1 plus 1 by 2 V1 square plus H1 plus Q equal to G Z2 plus V2 square by 2 plus H2 plus W. And the assumptions, so the device is insulated, Q equal to 0. There is no change in the potential energy Z1 equal to Z2, and there is no change in the kinetic energy V1 equal to V2. And finally, this is what the left out, H1 equal to H2 plus W, or W equal to H1 minus H2. So the power produced by the device P equal to M into H1 minus H2. So when the values, we assumed that Q equal to 0, V1 equal to V2, Z1 equal to U2, Z2. But if the values are given, you have to write the general equation and substitute the values, find out the work done. So in a turbine, pump, compressor, blower, fan, we have to find out the work done based on the availability of data. So if all the informations are given, we have to find out the W, write the equation, substitute all the values and find out what is the work output. Then you find out the power of the device. And the throttling device, so this is what the throttling device, it is very simple. The valve available in the pipeline. So the ideal gas is left side, temperature is T1, enthalpy is H1, and it is throttled, that is partially opened and closed. So T2 equal to T1 and H1 equal to H2. That is what the condition for throttling device. So when the partial, when the fluid flow through a partially opened valve, the flow is to be throttled. So when you have partial opening, it is called as throttling. And in the steady flow energy equation, the assumptions are Q equal to 0, W equal to 0, there is no change in the kinetic and the potential energy, and for throttling device, H1 equal to H2, that is the condition. So just remember, throttling device, H1 equal to H2, enthalpy before throttling is equal to enthalpy after throttling. So the next device is heat exchanger. So here we have the heat exchanger. In the heat exchanger, the heat is transferred from hot fluid to the cold fluid, and here hot oil is entering with the mass flow rate MH and inlet temperature THI, and flows through the heat exchanger and leaving with the temperature THO. Cold water is flowing through the pipeline, entering with the mass flow rate MC and inlet temperature TCI, and leaving with the temperature, outlet temperature TCO. So the general steady flow energy equation, we write the general steady flow energy equation, and it is GZ1 plus V1 square by 2 plus H1 plus Q equal to GZ2 plus V2 square by 2 plus H2 plus W. And the assumptions for heat exchanger are, heat exchanger is insulated, so Q equal to 0, there is no work done, W equal to 0, changes in the potential kinetic energy are small and ignored. So the steady flow energy equation for heat exchanger, finally, heat loss by the cold hot fluid is equal to heat gained by the cold fluid. So MH, CPH, PHI minus THO equal to MC, CPC, TCO minus TCI. This is the, using this equation, we can find out the unknown. The whatever is unknown, we can calculate the unknown for a heat exchanger. And again, we have a reflection spot. So based on our listening, we try to answer the question. Name the devices present in the application of steady flow energy equation. So what are the devices we have discussed? You write down, you take a piece of paper and you write down the various names of the devices, what we discussed in the application of steady flow energy equation. Okay, so the, if you have written all the devices listed here, nozzle, diffuser, turbine, compressor, fan, blower, pump, heat exchanger and throttling device, you are good. And these are the books I referred for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And if you have any queries or comments on the subject, comments on the presentation, you can write to me, to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer. And thank you for watching. We'll meet again.